got the Lumerol out again for a little experiment. So here's the formula for a 200 gram batch of what I'm going to call not soap. So first in, we're putting the Lumerol, and I'm using 70 grams, that's 35% of the recipe. This is what will emulsify and cleanse and rinse off the product. Then, because I want a bar, I'm adding a unrefined cocoa butter. Basically, I absolutely adore the smell, and also it's harder, so it'll enable us to use slightly less wax. So in that goes, I'm using 64.6 grams, that's 32.3% of the total recipe. After that, I'm adding coconut oil, liquid version fractionated, and I'm adding 20 grams or 10%. Then to harden the bar, I'm using candelilla wax, 20 grams or 10%. And I forgot that before that I also put in jojoba oil, 20 grams or 10% as well. If you kept up with that, well done. But you get it. There's Lumerol, there's cocoa butter, there's coconut oil, there's jojoba oil, and there's candelilla wax. Put all of that in a heatproof beaker, and then we're going to melt that in a bain-marie, which is just a pan with 1 to 2 inches of water in, and it just controls the heating process and so that your ingredients don't heat too fast or burn or, you know, something else. Anyway, can you tell I'm in a hurry to get these videos out this week? So when that's all melted, it should look a bit like this. Put it to the side because you'll want to leave that to get to 40 degrees C before you can add your cool down ingredients. Of course, this is where I forgot to turn the camera on because I'm that clever. What I did was I split the mixture into two beakers because I wanted two different colours. I used a bit of titanium dioxide in one to make it sort of more of a cream colour and neon pink in the other. And then what I'm going to do is pour it into the mould and just kind of layer the colours a little bit, like you would with a bar of soap. So I did that with the first one and then I messed it up a bit. And because I was taking so long, the other lot kind of solidified a little bit. So I thought, I'll just roll with it. And I patted it all down and tried to create another bar with that as it solidified, but realised that you can actually work with it a bit like when you're making cold processed soap. You can mould it a little bit and sculpt the top. Obviously I've done a terrible job here, but it was just to show that that can be done. It's obviously not soap because there's no sponification process that's taken place, but it uses, you know, a lot of the same oils and butters that I might put into a soap, and the Lumerol's causing the foaming. So what I'm going to call this is a foaming body butter bar because I think that's as close as what it is. Anyway, so I left those to cool down. I think I did put them in the freezer for a little bit just to speed up the process. I've got a lot of videos to make at the moment. And then when it came out, it felt like soap. I mean, it lathers like soap and it feels considerably more moisturising than most soap. So for the moment, I'm saying this is a win. The only downsides of this bar, I'd say, are because obviously it's butters and oils, it does melt. So if you're using it in the shower, you'll pretty much use half a bar up in one go. So it's not really that cost effective. But as far as a fun little experiment and something luxurious to make for yourself, then go for it, because this is really, really, really nice. And the feel on your hands after you've used it is just, it's lovely. It's like you've used a lovely body butter, but you've also washed with it. It's perfect. So here's the one that I did where I moulded the top. I'd say if you're going to mould it, you'd perhaps need a tiny bit more wax. Or, you know, perhaps a bit more butter, a bit more wax, just to harden it very slightly, because once it gets in the shower with hot water, it did melt down very quick and then you just lose that texture on top. But otherwise, quite happy as an experiment, quite pleased with how this went. So let's give this one a go as well. And yeah, I hope you like it. You're probably sick of Lumerol now. Places you can buy Lumerol, the Soap Kitchen and aromantic.co.uk in the UK. I think they sold out after Tara and I did a collab recently. I'm guessing they will restock. I'm afraid I don't know anywhere else that sells it. I know people keep asking. I'm sure they'll restock and you'll be able to get it again another time. And I'll do some more videos without using it so that you'll have ingredients that you already have or know next time. But anyway, I hope you like this random experiment. Sorry about the manic nature of it. I'm filming a lot of videos for you over the Christmas break, so hopefully I'll have lots of stuff for you in the new year. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and thanks for watching.